run large fleets of vehicles for people taking further, like the UN and refugee products around projects around the world. The people that ran this workshop were in charge of making sure a lot of people didn't die by delivery. Talking to them over the course of the day, figuring out what types of choices agency they had in these types of systems, and so that we could build something and talk about the types of choices they have and make better choices in the future. And this is all the key design. When we're investigating a system with people, we try to find the players in that system first and ask them what's going on. So when we create something like this, which is sort of the end result, it's player-centered in that the play experience for the game in this case is centered around the actual experience of people on the ground.
Yeah, and the fun thing about this project was we started off with a completely different game. It was a game about sending resources to crisis-ridden parts of the world. And our focus on which parts we thought were more important were really not what the players cared about. So we had to kind of do a 360 and change what we thought was important. And this process has happened again and again. And we feel that the stronger projects we make are the ones that are built with input from the players from the get-go.
So what other factors have been overlooked? We can start talking about the power-ups that you might have in a game system at this point, and it allows people to be more creative and find those new solutions that they may not have before. And this is really sort of one of the core issues that we feel games are good at, and what do we try to do, the things we try to do with all of our projects.
And systems are hard to understand. A system by itself is not compelling, it's not interesting, it's not even evocative. But they have, when we position the system from the point of view of the player can engage with it, the player can play with it, they can change the system based on how they feel it should work.
And they're efficient, but systems are efficient frameworks for visualizing the world. And there's all kinds of interconnectedness and complexities out there yet to be discovered. And we have new tools for graphing those. But when you do that, it's tough to see a personal, individual touch inside of all of this. And so that's why we think about players inside of systems first.
Yeah, many of our projects, if you go check out our website, deal with climate change. And the reason for that was that I had a lot of trouble sort of understanding these giant global systems and where do I fit into it. But if you have ever seen a climate change model, if it even has a human element, it's often highly abstracted. It makes it hard to understand why should I care about this, why should this matter to me. And I felt like that was a really compelling use case to try to change the conversation. And by using play, individuals can have an impact on climate change models, and that might help them understand what impact they might be having in the real world that they can't visualize as well.
Yeah, that's a really good example of that. What we're trying to talk about here is infrastructure diversity and resilience in the face of climate change. Where is the individual in this? But if we play with these ideas, you can find the individual, like agency and influence inside of these systems. And then it expands into the world as it now exists. How can we expose the impact the player has on these systems?
If you're a player in the real world, as well we all are, and you can imagine the horizon of your possibilities in your agency, with play you have the tools to expand it and to adapt it.
And we, in this way, we feel like games are speculative fiction for like real world systems. We first sort of codify the system as we believe it to be.
And then through play, imagine new ways to interact, and that creates new possibilities that people can actually act upon.
And then play in this context, we're having a conversation about what we believe the future should be together. Mm-hmm. If we have these abstracted ideas of what systems are, and then we play with them with each other, then we're having a great conversation, and it's really exciting. It's why we're all here. It's why we're interested in what we do.
Yeah, and with player-centered design, we invite people to design a playful experience with us, based on their own experiences. So really, they're teaching us how to understand their point of view through play, expanding the power dynamics of well-intentioned projects, which can often get problematic. Core stakeholders are more often than not very vaguely related to the solution that impact them the most. And with player-centered design, our radical revision of this power dynamic is placing the player at the front and center of the get-go.
So it's not about necessarily who's playing, but also who's not playing. How can we expand the number of voices of people in the process?
Of building solutions, yeah.
And if that conversation expanded, we can find a better solution for all of us together. So again, we try to put players as an active participants as well. It's not just about asking them, it's about going back to players and talking to them, like, did we do this right? What do you think should be changed? Can we talk a little bit more?
Yeah, and prioritization of this intended context of change-making projects, which makes them more resilient, specific, and sustainable is really our goal. And the way to do that, in our experience, has been to bring in the stakeholders really early on and have them invest in and have a buy-in into the solution so they sustain after our engagement has ended with them.
So we're not looking for one solution. We're looking for a process of solutions together and a process of conversation together. That's what player-centered design is about.
And we leave you with the hope that strategies such as this will lead to a greater understanding of each other and the world out there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you both very much. Obviously, if you guys are interested in speaking to these two, I'm sure they'll be happy to talk to you either in the lobby or you can catch them later. We're going to switch over to a panel model now. It'll take us just a couple minutes to get everybody up and rolling here. So let's do a nice quick switch over for folks that are ready to hit another slide.